Hey guys, it's Richard from Day Zero Gamer doing an unboxing of the Dark Knight Manual. So this is kind of a special unboxing. We tend to do games, pretty much. I mean, you can kind of look through our history. But we've done a couple books in the past, two of which are the Star Wars books, the Jedi Path and the Book of Sith. And the reason why we did those is because they were kind of special. Well, this is kind of a special book as well. So this is the day that The Dark Knight Rises hits theaters. Pretty nuts. The movie's nuts. But this book is pretty cool. It's kind of the same idea as the Star Wars books. So it's kind of written in lore or in the universe. So it's not meant to be kind of like a photo book or a picture book. It's actually meant to be sort of like a prop replica. The stuff inside, which once we open it up and take a look, you kind of see what I'm talking about. So here's the book. It's shrink wrapped, and there's a very good reason why. So let's go ahead and open this up. Careful here not to cut any of the pages or anything. Okay, so let's tear this open and get to the goodies. I can open it. All right. So first thing is it is hardbound, which is fantastic. And again, the shrink wrap, very important. Okay, so here's the book. It has a slip paper on it. Okay, so let me slide this off. So I can figure it out. Okay, so slide the little piece of paper here off, which kind of talks about what's inside. Shows there's a schematic of the cowl and all those goodies. So piece of paper. So this thing looks kind of worn, kind of battle damaged. Pretty cool. But you can see it's somewhat embossed. Of course, hardbound. It's a spine. Let's open it up. Looks like it's an ad. So there is the book. The inside looks nice. And starts off Batman. So the whole kicker is that this book is kind of like Star Wars, which you should definitely check out the unboxings for that. But everything in the book is done in the world, in the lore. So here is a police report, the murder of the Waynes, a newspaper clipping here. Everything is just essentially written from the point of view of Bruce Wayne. So he makes notes. There's a little stick, a post-it note from the desk of Wayne down here. Pretty sweet. And everything, again, is just done in this lore. Here's a little slide out. Pull it out here. Let's take a look. So this looks like a blueprint. Looks like it's the Batcave. So you can kind of see. Close up here. Measurements and everything like that. Pretty sweet. Awesome to be framed, for sure. Let's put it back in its little home. And each page, I mean, seriously, this is something that looks like it would be fun just to read and go through everything and then just kind of get immersed, because every page, just about, has something that comes out. It's kind of like a pop-up in a way. I mean, sort of. Just a bunch of goodies. I mean, here's another post-it note. Let's see, Applied Sciences. This is from Alfred. Pretty sweet. Just tons. Everything from the bat suit. It looks like there's this rough drafts of the symbol, the bat symbol. So that's cool. I saw something before. Let me see. We don't go through every page here. I think there was something specific. I can find it. Everything from his suit, the tech behind the weapons. There's another blueprint, it looks like. Ah, so this is from the Dark Knight Rises. You can see a schematic of that blueprint. Very cool. Again, totally frame worthy. It's done very, very well. And I mean, for me, I'm just a huge Batman fan, but I'm a sucker for this kind of stuff where they're literally props. It's like prop replicas inside of the book. So you buy this book, and not only do you have all the cool literature and all the stuff that they put inside the book itself, but you have all the little goodies. Harvey Dent stickers. I mean, defaced, looks like by Joker. Files, Dr. Crane's files. I mean, that's fantastic. There's just so much in here. It's kind of hard to go over it all. But there's something, here we go. I think is this the area? Yeah, okay. So of course, you get to the Joker. We go through all the files and stuff like that. So it's classified, it has stuff about the Joker. Come over here to this page, and there are evidence folders. It's the Joker's cards, so you can kind of pull them out right here. Pretty sweet. It's the ones that he like left at the scenes or whatnot. Pretty awesome. More Joker cards. It's just little things like that to me just sets this book apart from other books. I mean, it isn't something where you're just reading the book and you get a bunch of what's your stuff about the franchise? I mean, you actually have props. I'm going to leave this out. Look at this. It's kind of cool. And again, just the presentation is sweet. And almost everything. All the pages are kind of like different too. They're not all glossy. Some of them have, like I said, the post-it notes. But just the entire presentation really is sound. And at the very end, it looks like there's a little folder here. Something hidden. Oh wow, so it looks like it's a map. So here's a folder. It's a map of Gotham. Wow. That's quite fantastic. So definitely for the Nolan fans, for the Batman, sorry I bumped the camera, the Nolan Batman fans, I mean it's an entire map of Gotham City. So just alone for the stuff inside, the goodies inside, it's definitely something I'd recommend. Again, there's just so much stuff in here, it would take forever to go over it all. But it's worth the time. Definitely take a look. I recommend it. And see the movie. Gotta see the movie. And there we go.